Now, I miss some of the other campaigners that have dropped out of the race at this point. John McCain, of course. At the beginning, all of the reporters were seeing which one would be the first that could make him lose his temper. You know, and they would ask him these questions and hope, and he would kind of be, he had this combination snarl and smile, which is why the Secret Service had his code name as Rottweiler. But then the reporters began to change. He charmed them, or rather, they charmed themselves, because, you know, a reporter would ask him on the straight talk bus, well, what do you think of what's happening with the Falun Gong? And he says, oh, you know, I haven't followed those punk bands, really. So the reporter would say, no, the Falun Gong are these meditators in China, and they're being arrested for just doing their exercises. So then he gives a speech that night, and he says, we in America here are free, not like in China where the Falun Gong gets persecuted. And the reporter would write down, he had a brilliant insight tonight. So, you know, he just, he came on, everybody was excited. He's talking about campaign finance reform. There are already laws for that. I think it's the laws against aggressive panhandling should cover that. And the other solution would be that all donations to a campaign would have to be done anonymously. So then anybody could go to a candidate and say, did you get that money I sent? And they wouldn't know the difference. But, you know, McCain just could not suppress himself. You know, he'd go to Vietnam on the 25th anniversary and said, my fellow gooks, you know. But the moment I remember from the debates was when George Bush Sr., of course, had said, no new taxes, read my lips. So his son, George W., had to be especially careful. So he said, I will cut taxes, so help me God. And then McCain says, well, but I said I was going to cut taxes, and my tax cut is bigger than your tax cut. And then he said, yeah, mine is bigger than yours. And I thought, here was it, a dick joke from a presidential candidate. The other candidates I miss, Gary Bauer, for example, everybody couldn't decide who he reminded them of. You know, was it an alien from outer space? Or was it a ventriloquist dummy? And then I realized he revealed it himself when he said that we should have a fetus sitting at the table. And that was it. He looks like a fetus. And Alan Keyes. Now, Alan Keyes, here was a guy who's, you know, this flailing his arms preacher type, the only African-American candidate in this race. And he would, he came from a military family. And he was against gays in the military because he said that it would make the other men in the barracks uncomfortable to have a gay person sleeping in the same barracks with them. And, you know, you want to say to him, look, Ambassador Keyes, how can you say that when that's the same thing they said about blacks, that, you know, the men didn't want to have black soldiers sleeping in the same barracks because it would make them uncomfortable. And Alan Keyes said, yes, but we never told anybody we were black. This was the forerunner of the don't ask, don't tell policy.